First of all, thank you very much to the Edmund Burke Foundation. Thank you to Yoram Hazony. Thank you to Anna, to Michael, and to all the great staff for organizing this amazing conference here in Italy, here in Rome. And we are very happy as Nazione Futura to be the Italian partner of this conference. In recent years, words such as sovranismo and sovereignty have been used with an increasing frequency in the public debate. To prove the importance of these ideas, we must remember that the Article 1 of the Italian Constitution states that sovereignty belongs to the people. Until a few years ago, according to the public perception, Italy was a full-fledged sovereignty state. But already in the 90s, a series of signs that national sovereignty has been limited in favor of supranational entities began to emerge. The Italian citizens actually began to feel the weakening of the state authority in the relation with the European Union, with the introduction of the single currency and the choice to adopt the euro in Italy. It was a latent sovereignty restriction which became clearer with the 2008 crisis. In a political context where the contrast between the right and the left seemed to have been replaced by new categories, we are living a new differentiation between the egalitarian party with the globalistic view of the society and, on the other side, the sovereignist and the conservative bloc. The words of the former president of the European Commission, Juncker, at the University of Leeds sum up clearly the current conflict. In his opinion, in fact, we must tackle stupid populism and nationalism. We must look at what the Europe has built. We have developed a borderless European Union. We have created a single currency, and now we have to strengthen the role of the euro. If, on the one hand, Juncker talk about a borderless Europe, on the other hand, the sovereignists hope for a Europe in which borders still maintain a specific value and meaning. Sovereignism spread in Europe not just because of identity reason, but also because of the financial factor. Brexit, in fact, is a vote against globalization. It's a protest vote made by the people who experienced the negative effect of the globalization. Building on the United Kingdom election result, the analysis could be applied to the whole Europe to explain the choice made by the citizens in search of protection in favor of the sovereignist parties, hoping this could do something about the institution of the European Union, who took unfavorable decision for them. In Europe, we are living a bump in the sovereignist party and also in the conservative party, sure. Even though this often didn't reach the government. The most remarkable factor in the European election in Italy is the Lega triumph with the 34% of the vote, and now Brother of Italy, yesterday we heard the speech of Giorgia Meloni, is at 10% according to the polls, establishing the victory of the sovereignist thinking in the Italian political landscape. The result of the European election in our country, above all expectation for the party, underlies Matteo Salvini's communication strategy, his firmness on the immigration issue, and the Italian people's request for an identity policy focusing on the national interest. And the national interest is actually the heart of the Lega sovereignism, but in the same time, it's well represented by Fratelli d'Italia, Brother of Italy. So the sovereignist and the conservative landscape is dividing into big areas. The first one is closer to the conservatism and represented by Fratelli d'Italia, and it's not a coincidence that Giorgia Meloni put into her party symbol the word conservative and sovranisti, and the majority of the Lega component with a somewhat more fluid identity. Different souls, which are also represented at the European level by the sovereignist party with their different identities, summing up perfectly the post-ideological character assumed by the sovereignist party, or national populist, to quote a book written by Matthew Godwin, across the world continent. But besides the success of the sovereignist parties, the Italian vote during the European election deserves some remarks. First, the fluidity of the vote and the collapse of the five-star movement. The five-star movement is a populistic movement that passed from the 33 of the last general election to the 17% in the European election. The inconsistency of the fascist menace, We are living in recent years a political and media campaign about the risk of a return of fascism if sovereignist and conservative party will be victorious. But the truth is that fascism ended in 1945 with the death of Mussolini, as explained by Renzo De Felice. Renzo De Felice is the main historian of fascism, and he was close to the Italian Communist Party. Another important point is the difference between the big city and the suburban areas. The division between the big city and the countryside. If the left-wing parties' electorates live in the big city, the electorates of the Conservative and Sovereignist Party live in the countryside. In this context, the PPE choice to make an alliance with the Social Democrats and the impossibility to form a majority of Popular Party, Sovereignist and Conservative, brought the inability to choose the appointment of the European Commission. In any case, although far from being a majority, the presence of sovereignists within the European Parliament has increased, and it has a great role compared to the last parliamentary term. The lack of a unified group is of course a weakness for the sovereignist force, but if the party will be able to find a common ground despite their difference, the chance to make a difference in the European Union will increase. It's the idea of the nation that should be put at the center of Europe to build a land of nations. Even though the Sovereignist and Conservative Party are far from the majority in the European Parliament, the European election establishes an important alternative view of the EU and the chance to develop a common project in the next year. In this respect, the elections must be considered as a starting point, not as an arrival point, to develop a bigger sovereignist and conservative international. To create it and understand what sovereignism really is, it's important to start from an assertion. The sovereignist party are not at all against the idea of Europe itself. They are, in fact, European political forces opposing to the current setting up of the European Union. Saying that the Sovereignist and Conservative Party are anti-Europe is a mistake, as it would be asserted that Sovereignist Party are against Europe. This means not to understand the Sovereignist and the Conservative Party demands, which not only see the European history as a part of their identity, but the fight to defend it from the attack and the attempt to reject the core values of Europe. The Sovereignists are against the current European Union policy. They judge it distant from citizens' needs. That is why they are making every necessary effort to review it. The view on the European Union have changed also, and the vast majority of sovereignists want to change the European Union. The main standpoint is the creation of the new European project founded upon a confederation of sovereign nations where the individual nation have more power and autonomy while being united by common view on some macro areas, such as foreign affairs. In Italian perspective, the problem that arises in developing such a project is given by the French and the German dominion. We're great friends of German and French people, but not in the decision made by Macron and Merkel. On the 23rd January of the last year, France and Germany have signed a cooperation treaty at Aachen, a full-fledged political agreement made by Merkel and Macron that shows the aspiration of two hegemony of the two nations at a European level, and therefore within the European Union policy. So today we are facing the risk of an increasing centralization of powers in the hand of the community bodies, with more and more cession of sovereignty from the national state that would increase the Bruxelles establishment power at the expense of nation. First and foremost, Italy, which is the third European Union economy and the third largest nation for habitants. I finish. A nation such as Italy should follow a twin-track road. On one end, it's necessary to build alliance and strike stronger deal within the European Union, and so it's a desirable choose cooperation between Italy, the third economy in the European Union, and the Visegrad Group. On the other hand, it's necessary to develop bilateral relations outside the European Union to increase the weight of Italy both in political and economic terms, especially with the United States. I think this is the only way to build a different Europe, a Europe we can believe in, how Roger Scruton said. Thank you.